Hallelujah. It is well with you. It is well with your family. It is well with the works of your hand. It is very good to come and pray with you, to come to your home today. May the Lord bless and keep you and fulfill his counsels concerning you. It is well with your family. It is well with the works of your hand and everything that has your name on it, in the name of Jesus. The Spirit of God just laid in my spirit today to come and pray with you on a very, very important issue. What is that? We call it evil visitation. Evil visitation. When the enemy comes to visit you, hallelujah, we have the record of divine visitation in the scripture. We have when God visited Abraham and his wife Sarah, they've been waiting for the Lord to bless them with their own child for so long, until when God visited them. When God visited them, it turned impossible to possibility. Hallelujah. It turned impossibility to possibility. And that will be your case in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will turn your situation around, and impossibility will become possibility in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. But when we are talking about evil visitation, let's look at what the scripture says. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 13 verse 25, the Bible says, but while he was sleeping, his enemy came and saw also Daniel, which is wheat resembling wheat among the wheat, and went on his ways, and went on his ways. The enemy only comes when you are weak, because they know that when they come, when you are strengthened, when you are strong, they will not be successful in the assignment. So that's why they always come when you are weak. They always come when you are vulnerable. That's why they come when you are asleep, because they know that you have the fire of God in you as a child of the kingdom. You have the Spirit of God in you, and they cannot withstand the power of God that is all over you. So that's why they come when you are asleep. Hallelujah. Have you ever find yourself in a situation that when you wake up in the morning, you find all these scratches all over your body? All over your body. That is not normal. That is not of God. That is the manifestation of evil visitation. The enemy had visited you overnight. Hallelujah. And all the evil mark upon your body, the mark of the blood of Jesus Christ, we raise it today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know what the scripture says? The Bible says, henceforth, let no man trouble me, for I bear in my body the mark of Jesus Christ. It's only the mark of Jesus Christ that will remain on you in the mighty name of Jesus. Every strange mark, every evil mark that the enemy has placed upon your body and upon your life, I raise it today by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. When we are talking about evil visitation, listen carefully. When we are talking about evil visitation, have you been in the situation that you experienced this, what we call spiritual paralysis? This spiritual paralysis, that though you are awake, you are not asleep, but you cannot move, you cannot speak, you cannot lift your arm, you cannot lift your leg, you cannot do anything. It's only inside of you that you know that you are still alive, but something is pressing you down. Oh, that is an evil visitation. That's an evil visitation. And they don't just come for nothing. They come to sow seed. They come to sow seed. And so many times when they come to sow seed, this seed, you don't see it immediately. Because when you see it, it resembles good seed. But they are not. They are not. They are not. That's why some people, when you see goods coming your way, you pursue it. Actually, it's the works of the devil. So they can distract you from the good that God has prepared for you. They want to keep you occupied pursuing vanity, pursuing something that will not bring good result. But to you, it looks good, it sounds good, it feels good, but it's not good. When you have the Spirit of God in you, the Spirit of God that's in you will let you know that this is not good and it's not of God. Hallelujah. The enemy just wants to distract you. The enemy enemy just wants to keep you occupied so that you will not be able to wait for the things that God has prepared and designed with your name on it. Hallelujah. But today, the power of God will expose every plan and agenda of the wicked concerning your life in the name of Jesus Christ. And the will and the purpose of God alone in your life will be established in the name of Jesus Christ. When we are talking about evil visitation, it was an evil visitation when you find yourself in the dream, you are eating and they are feeding you. And guess what? They will feed you with your best dishes ever, with the food that you love the most. That's what they feed you in the dream. But I want to tell you, eating in the dream when you are asleep, it's not good. It's evil, because through this, they sow evil seeds into your body. They hinder your progress. They delay the plan of God for you. They put sicknesses and infirmity and diseases in your body. And when you notice you have all this dream, when you are pursuing good things, you are expecting a miracle to happen, they use it to take away your blessing. But today, the power of God will put an end to it in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Lord will reverse everything that the enemy has done in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Today is your day, and this is your moment. When we are talking about evil visitation, what about you finding yourself having sex in the dream? Somebody came to visit you. You find yourself on a date in the dream. You find yourself, you having a guest in the dream. Oh, I want to tell you today, those are not good. Those are evil visitation. But enough is enough for spiritual aspect of it. What about physically? When you have a guest in your home, but the agenda is not just to come and visit you or to wish you well, but the agenda is to come and sow evil seed or to destroy what God is doing in your life. No matter what it is, no matter who it is, in the name of Jesus, the Lord, we expose them today in the name of Jesus Christ. And we destroy every works of the devil. The Bible says, for this reason, the Son of God was manifested, that he may destroy the works of the devil. Oh, I want you to join me in prayer right now. I want you to come in agreement with me. Just stretch forth your hand towards the screen and let the power of God flow into your life. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost rest upon you now. And I want you to believe. Because the Bible says, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. No matter what it is that an evil visitor has done in your life today, the power of God will transform your life and reverse everything that the enemy had done and destroy the works of the devil in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I stand on your word today. As you have sent me, here I am, O God, praying with your people in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I hereby cover myself in the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover this one under the sound of my voice in the blood of Jesus today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I hereby release the fire of God to destroy every work of evil visitors that they have done in your life, in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover you with the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that whenever, any power anywhere, any spirit anywhere, or evil agent of the devil, whenever they try to come to visit you, in the name of Jesus Christ, the power of the Holy Ghost, we arrest them in the name of Jesus Christ. And no matter the seed they've sown into your life, I decree today by the authority and power that's in the name of Jesus Christ, I decree that it is destroyed. I set those evil seed on fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you have been under the bondage of evil paralysis, if you have been under the bondage of spiritual oppression, in the name of Jesus, the power of God set you free today. The mighty hand of God liberates you in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, I set your life on fire. I set your home on fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, whenever they come to visit you, the fire of God will consume them, because the word of God is written. The Bible says fire goes before the Lord and destroy all his enemies on every side, in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are a child of the kingdom, born of the spirit, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Whenever there's an evil visitation, an evil visitor that come to visit you, the fire of God will consume the works of their head. The fire of God will arrest them in the name of Jesus. I pray that the fire of God exposes them today in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the enemy had done and they thought they have accomplished in your life, in the name of Jesus Christ, I call it destroyed. I reverse it today. And that very thing, that which the enemy doesn't want me to manifest in your life, I command it to begin to manifest. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let the glory of God begin to manifest in your life. Let the power of God begin to manifest in your life. Let the grace of the Almighty begin to manifest in your life. I command your blessing, your miracle, your breakthrough to begin to manifest right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And the power of the enemy will not be able to hinder what God is about to do in your life. What God is doing in your life right now shall not be hindered. It shall not be delayed in the name of Jesus Christ. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed upon you. All eyes shall see it, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are free today from this bondage, from the bondage of evil visitation. You are free today. You are free indeed. The Bible says the angels of the Lord encamps round about those who fear him. I hereby pray that you are surrounded by the angels of God right now. The angels of God build a hedge of fire, hedge of protection around you and your household in the name of Jesus Christ. No more evil visitation. In the name of Jesus, it comes to an end today. In the name of Jesus, instead of evil visitation, experience divine visitation. Experience divine visitation. In the name of Jesus, the Lord himself will visit you today. The glory of the Lord will rest upon you today. The mighty hand of God will rest upon you today. Fresh anointing from heaven rest upon you today in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Oh, we bless your name for what you have done again this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessed be your name forever. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. It is well with you, with your family, and with your household. We would love to hear your testimony. Please send us a message. Let us know what God is doing in your life. And we will continue to pray for you and with you in Jesus' name. God bless you.